So let me just open up the session by welcoming all our elders who have joined us on the Elder Hour. As all of you know, we've been celebrating Elder Hour for more than 1.5 months now. And from 15th of June onwards, it's been a complete marathon doing Elder Hour every day from Tuesday to Saturday. Malini Goyalji, who's with us on the session today. Malini, thank you so much for joining us on the session today. Really, really a huge honor and a pleasure to have you with us on the show, and to really bring the power of what you represent for all of us. Just so that all of us at the show knows who we are discussing with. So Malini has been a business journalist for over 25 years. Are you completing 25 years, Malini, this year?
It will be around 28 years. It's been a long ride.
Wow. So this is quite a long career spanning 25, 27 years. And this is a very illustrious journalism career. And Malini has been with media publications like Economic Times, India Today, Forbes India magazine, and I think a brief stint at Seattle Post Intelligencer in the US. Malini, this one was really interesting. So you must share with us in the show about that Seattle Post Intelligencer in the US.
Bilkul.
It caught my attention, and I thought I will reserve this question for you during the show.
Sure, Swamiji. Thank you so much for such a good introduction, such a deep introduction. And probably separately, I'll sort of talk a little bit about my journey. But just answering your question on why elder care. So, of course, some of it is vested interest, right? You see your parents. And for a journalist, I think most of the time, story ideas come out of interactions with people. And at least my story ideas come out of that. You know, I look at job market very closely, and also I look at many other markets very closely. So most of the stories come out of that, and the senior stories actually came out of that. And I remember around 5 years back, I didn't know at all anything about senior living at that point of time. And I had somebody mentioned about Ashiana Bhiwadi, and I made a visit there, and I wanted to interview some seniors, just trying to understand how they are coping with technology at that point of time. That was the trigger. And I definitely saw my parents kind of struggle with it. My dad is around 80, 82, and my mom is around 74. So they are relatively old, but at that point of time, they were struggling. And I was also experiencing that, they were very lonely. You know, they stayed close to me, and we were trying to spend as much time with them. But, our daily job, we have our own family commitments. I have a son to look after. At that point of time, he was very small. And I realized that my parents felt very lonely. The trigger was from, different things at different points of time. And I happened to visit Ashiana Bhiwadi. And the conversation there at that point of time, something told me everybody felt very happy there. And, I would have interviewed, 10, 15 odd people. I didn't feel that, it was all fudged up, People were genuinely very happy. So at that point of time, when I came back, we were discussing this, and I told my dad that, at some point of time, I would want to sort of move into a place like that. One of the biggest thing was, peer group, socializing, right? If you are not living in a senior living community and you are living outside, you are always on the fringes of the society, and I feel that where I'm living, right, things are not geared towards them. Ya to ghare aisi bani padi hai ki unke hisab se nahi hai. Sometimes hamare yahan par lift nahi kaam karta hai, and I know that seniors are kind of struggling with that. Or even just that, things that we organize, our annual day, we organize in the campus that we live in. So it is not gearing towards that. So one is that life and lifestyle does not cater to the needs of seniors, right? They may be old, but it's not that they don't want to live life. They want to live a different kind of life. So that's one. Second is, I think, the peer group, which is extremely important. It's important at every stage of life, but it's especially important in old age when, you know, you're not actively working, you're not busy with a day job, all that. So that was true even for my parents. And third is, especially in India, that many of the parents who've lived all their lives bringing up their children, that they did not live their own life well, right? They were just so busy. There was little financial bandwidth or time bandwidth. ये फुर्सती नहीं थी और बहुत सारे विश लिस्ट में बहुत सारी चीजें हैं जो वो करना चाहते हैं वो कर नहीं पाए टू लुक एट इट वन इज दैट इफ पेरेंट्स देमसेल्व्स वांट टू मूव और नॉट इफ दे डोंट वांट टू मूव एंड यू आर फोर्सिंग देम टू मूव देन इट्स अ नो नो आई मीन सो एंड मेनी टाइम्स देयर इज दिस मेंटल ब्लॉक पेरेंट्स हैव एंड समटाइम्स मेंटल ब्लॉक दैट चिल्ड्रन हैव चिल्ड्रन आर इजीयर टू डील विद ऑन दिस बट इफ पेरेंट्स हैव अ मेंटल ब्लॉक इट्स वेरी हार्ड टू डू इट And I know there are people here in my campus, they have that. You know, I can see it. Oh, you've sent your mom to senior living and you know where they're coming from, right? So they have this mental block. So unless they get over that, it's very difficult to deal with it.
Malini, over to you to your concluding thoughts, anything that you would like to share. I can only say that it's such a privilege to have you on the show. Elder hour as a concept means making that one call every day so okay. that your parents feel good. And that one little call makes a difference. And that is what Imoha kind of wants to do to make a difference in the life of an elder. You have been a wonderful daughter yourself. And, you know, in my own one-on-one conversations with yourself, I can see the I can see the mohabbat that is there between you and your parents, which has made you take those calls. How would you like to leave us with thoughts?
Thanks so much, Swamijit, and lovely to sort of catch up with you all and see another world, right? As a journalist, there is this business world that I look at. So this adds another perspective to it and thoroughly enjoyed the conversation, Swamijit. And a lot of takeaways for me in terms of technology, media, all that. But thanks so much for inviting me and I'm sure Imoha fits into a lot of new age product and services that we need today. So, you know, while India is a young nation, we have a very significant population, if you've seen millions, right? Okay. And I think we should begin to think about their needs and their product and services and how companies can aggregate the community there and cater to them. So I definitely see an Imoha is a good step in that direction. The kind of sounding sort of endorsement you are getting from there is kind of witness to that. So thanks so much again for everybody for joining in. It was a pleasure catching up with you all.
No, I think the pleasure is all ours, Malini. I have seen over the years how journalism and awareness perhaps is the one and the most important thing. And it is not about Imoha, it is not about elder care services, it is all for the elders. Because, you know, we have in the speed and the interest of taking care of the 350 million youngsters of the country, somewhere forgotten the, you know, the power yes. and the importance of our elders. Absolutely. And we say elders first is a ritual and a culture and a religion at Imoha. It's not for just saying elders first. It's because when an elder, you know, passes away, we have so many elders who passed away during COVID. Some of them were part of Imoha ourselves. I miss them. I miss them every day. You know, these are elders who are libraries. They like the library, the books library that is right behind you, Malini. I can see the book, beautiful bookshelves. Every elder is like a book library, right? And so how we can make that library more beautiful, more effective, it is with senior journalists like yourself and your contribution and your support that everybody benefits. Elders become more relevant for mainstream journalism. And so thank you so much. Thanks again. Wonderful way you cover this. Thanks for spending time with us and looking Thanks. Forward to, you know, keeping on inviting you in such sessions.
Absolutely. Look forward, Swamiji. Thank you, everybody.
Thank you, Malini.
Thank you, everybody. Thank you. Have a good evening. Thank you. We'll catch up again.
Thanks, Swamiji.
Take care. Take care.
Thank you,
Renu aunty.
God bless you, Swamiji. Daily, we are very much,
bye.
You know.
We don't have the power. Thank you.